Welcome back to another episode that is about problem number 14-22. This problem is taken from chapter number 14, Energy Methods, and book name is Mechanics of Material by R.C. Hibbeler. So statement of this problem is determine the bending strain energy in the beam and the axial strain energy in each of two posts. All the members are made up of aluminum having a square cross section 50 mm by 50 mm. Assume the post only support vertical axial load. Modulus of elasticity of aluminum is 70 kPa. So you can see this is the beam and the loading is shown. There is a distributed load of 8 kN per meter and there are two vertical posts that support this beam. So you have to find the bending strain energy in this beam and axial strain energy in this vertical post. So this vertical post offer only vertical reaction. So let's start with the solution. So what if we remove this post, two posts? So this will apply a vertical reaction on this beam. Let this is the beam. You can see this is the load that due to this post. So this is P of that this the load that this post apply on the beam is P of post. And similarly on other side the same length or same material post is applying a load P of post on this beam. There is a uniformly distributed load on this beam which is given as 8 kN per meter there, and this load is downward. So we will find this P of post by using equation of equilibrium. So what will be the equation of equilibrium? So first step is that we will convert this distributed load into a point load. So this will be equal to 8 kN per meter multiplied by the length, and the total length of this beam is given as 3 meter. So I will multiply it with 3. So this 3 meter. So this will give you 24 kN load, and that will act at a distance of 3 divided by 2, which is 1.5 meter from either side. Clear? Okay, now we will apply equation of equilibrium. So you can see the sum of all forces along y direction must be equal to zero and upward force is taken as positive. So P of post plus P of post. P of post is the load that this post apply on this beam. Minus 24 is equal to zero. So 2 times P of post is equal to 24. So it means that P of each post apply a 12 kN load on this beam. Clear? Now we will move further, and what we will do is that we will cut this beam at any length x. Clear? And we will draw the free body diagram in order to find the equation for movement. So look, you can see this is the beam. Here we have one load P of post which is equal to 12 into 10 to the power 3 newton. Clear? And this total length of the beam where we cut it is x, and there is a uniformly distributed load on this which is 8 kN per meter. So when you cut it, you will be having a shear force and you will be having a moment. This is your point one. So what we will do is that we will convert first this distributed load into a point load. So this will be equal to 8 multiplied by 8 kN. So 8 into 10 to the power 3 multiplied by this length x, or which it act. And this will act at a distance of x by 2 from either side. So this distance will be x by 2. Now we'll find this moment by using equation of equilibrium, that sum of all moment about point 1 is equal to 0 and taking the counterclockwise moment as positive. So about point 1, one moment is this reaction moment which is counterclockwise, and that will be plus. The second moment will be due to this 8 into 10 to the power 3 into x, and the perpendicular distance is x by 2, and this is also counterclockwise, so it will be positive. So plus 8 into 10 to the power 3x multiplied by x by 2. And the last moment that is produced due to this load and perpendicular distance is x, and this is producing clockwise, so it will be negative. So I will write minus 12 into 10 to the power 3x is equal to 0. So what I will get is m plus 4 into 10 raised to the power 3 x square minus 12 into 10 raised to the power 3 x is equal to 0. So if you further simplify it, this moment will be equal to 12 into 10 raised to the power 3 x minus 4 into 10 raised to the power 3 x square, and its unit will be Newton into meter. Okay, now this is the equation of moment. So we will move toward finding the bending strain energy due to bending, and we know that this is equal to integral from 0 to L m square dx divided by 2EI. Okay, so put the value, integral 0 to L m square is 12 into 10 raised to the power 3x minus 4 into 10 raised to the power 3x square whole square into dx divided by 2EI. That is strain energy due to bending. Okay, now if you take this 1 over 2EI out of this integral, because these are constant, so you will left with 0 to L. So 12 into 10 raised to the power 3 square will be 144 into 10 raised to the power 6 x square minus plus 4 into 10 raised to the power 6, 10 raised to the power 3 will be 16 into 10 raised to the power 6 x power 4 minus 2 times this term multiplied by this term will give you, I will directly write it, this will give you minus 96 into 10 raised to the power 6 x cube into dx. That will be equal to strain energy due to bending. Okay, again this bending strain energy will be equal to 1 over 2EI, and what we will take is integral. So 144 into 10 raised to the power 6 x cube over 3, and limit will be from 0 to L plus 16 into 10 raised to the power 6 x 5 divided by 5, and limit from 0 to L minus 96 into 10 raised to the power 6 into x power 4 divided by 4, and limit from 0 to L. Okay, and you can see x start from 0 to x is equal to L, 3 meter, not L, 3. Total length is 3. So what is that? I will remove this L and I will write it 3. Okay, now we will find E of steel is given as 70 gigapascal, and it is given that this is square cross section 50 by 50. So the square cross section is this one. This is 50 millimeter, and the height is also 50 millimeter. Clear? So moment of inertia is equal to 1 over 12 BH cube. So 1 over 12, breadth is 50 and millimeter, in meter it is 0.05, and height is also 50, which is 0.05 meter whole cube. So when you calculate it, you will get 0.52083 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 meter power 4. Now you have all the values, so you can just put it 1 over 2 multiply by E is 70 gigapascal, 70 into 10 raised to the power 9 multiply by 0.520 into 10 raised to the power minus 6 multiply by all these values. 144 into 10 raised to the power 6 divided by 3x cube plus 16 into 10 raised to the power 6 x 5 divided by 5, limit will be from 0 to 3, here limit from 0 to 3, plus minus 96 into 10 raised to the power 6 x 4 divided by 4, limit from 0 to 3. Okay. So when you solve this, you will get 1777 joules, or that is equal to 1.78 kilojoule. So this is the amount of bending, this is the amount of strain energy that will be stored in the beam due to bending. Now what we will do is that we will find the axial strain energy. Axial strain energy. Let me write it here. This is bending strain energy. Okay. For axial strain energy, we know that strain energy due to axial loading is equal to integral of 0 to L n square dx divided by 2ae. Clear? So what we will do is that we have n is actually the normal load or axial load. So you can see the axial load of this post is ps, 12 kilonewton. This beam is applied 12 kilonewton load on this post. So I will write from 0 to L 12 kilonewton, so 12, and that is also equal to, since it is equal to n square L divided by 2ae. Okay, so 12 into 10 to the power 3 whole square. I will remove these things because this is already, we know that axial strain energy is equal to normal load square into L divided by 2ae. So if you write this or this, both will give you the same thing. And length of each post is 1.5 meter. So 1.5 divided by 2 times area. Area of this cross section is given. So area is 0.05 multiplied by 0.05. And E is 70 gigapascal, 70 to 10 to the power 9. That is due to axial loading. So when you calculate it, you will get strain energy due to axial loading will comes out to be 0.617 joule. So this is the amount of strain energy that will be stored in each of the post. Clear? And that was all about this problem 14-22. I hope you have enjoyed this video and you have learned from it. Those who are new to my channel, then subscribe it and don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notification about my latest videos. If you have any question, you can ask me in comment section. Also share my videos with your friends and help them in learning, as well as help me in growing my channel further. Thank you for watching and thank you for your supports.